So, hi, mein Name is Axel Herzschuch. I'm a PhD student from Technische Universität Dresden. And this presentation is about a simple yet fast and effective join ordering concept for arbitrary select project join queries. When talking about query optimization, researchers seem to agree on one thing, and that is cardinality estimation is the root of all evil. So why is that? A query optimizer commonly consists of three parts. That is first, the plan enumerator, which of course spans the search space. Second, the cost model to assess the cost of any given plan prior to its execution. And third, the cardinality estimator, which gives us most crucial input, the estimated size of intermediate results to the cost model. Therefore, as you can see, everything stays and falls with the cardinality estimator. For no surprise, cardinality estimation has been a vital research topic for over four decades now. The most outstanding thing is that we see a reoccurring interest of applying sampling to the problem of joint cardinality estimation. So of course, sampling is easy to implement, can handle arbitrary complex expressions within the select state of the select project join query pattern, and it comes without any prior knowledge of the data distribution. However, as it turns out, these methods do not scale very well in the number of joins. On the other hand, recent research applies machine learning to the problem of cardinality estimation. However, these methods do not support all relevant predicate types yet, and their training depends on executing a plethora of joins or using join sampling itself. So we can conclude the following challenges of arbitrary complex select project join queries. On the one side, we have to support arbitrary complex expressions within the filter state. And on the other hand, we need to scale within the number of joins. So to tackle these issues, our paper proposes a very simple yet fast and effective join ordering concept. Unfortunately, we cannot detail everything here. However, if you find some aspects appealing, please don't hesitate to look at our paper. So our approach is very pessimistic and therefore more passive without relying on very aggressive assumptions, magic constants, or dumping factors. We use a very simple upper bound for an arbitrary number of joins. Based on this upper bound, we apply our customized enumeration approach and use sampling only on the base tables to achieve very precise selectivity estimates. We use a customized sampling approach tailored for columnar stores. Let's get started with the upper bound and enumeration part of our approach. So let's assume we are given the estimated or exact size of two tables that need to join. In this example, it is R and S that need to join over attributes X and Y. So what is the worst possible outcome in terms of how big the query result can be? Of course, very few distinct values is a bad thing. And if all distinct values join, the query result really gets big. So virtually every database system comes with a statistic that is known as top K statistic or maximum frequency statistic, from which we get the maximum frequency any value can occur within attributes X and Y. In this example, we see that any value within attribute X can occur at most 5 times, while in attribute epsilon, we see a value can occur at most 2 times. As I said, we assume the worst possible thing, that is, we have all values with the maximum frequency occurring in the attributes. On X, we get 5 A's and 5 B's, whereas on epsilon, every value gets a maximum frequency of 2 A to E. Then, as I said, every value finds a join partner. So in the end, this gives us a multiplicity per value of 10, as we have 10 A's in the result and 10 B's in the result. And this really is an upper bound. However, as you can see on the right-hand side, where we give an example where we see more distinct values, this does not violate our upper bound. Things get only better. So for more details, please look at our paper, where you can also find the recursive definition for an arbitrary number of joins. So based on this upper bound, we apply our customized enumeration approach, where we start with applying all non-expanding operators in the first phase. Especially this means we push down the filters to the base tables and moreover treat the 1 to n, so therefore the non-expanding or primary key foreign key joins as special filters, as they can never expand but only reduce the size of a foreign key partner. Then for the more dangerous and potentially expanding end-to-end joins, we use our upper bound and apply a customized enumeration approach, which you can find in our paper. Okay, to show that our approach really works well in practice, we use the well-known join order benchmark, which consists of 113 select project join queries with up to 16 joins over real-world data. As competitors, we use Postgres as an example for a disk-centric row store and MonetDB as an example for an in-memory columnar store. Luckily, both systems are open source, so you're free to download our evaluation basis to further analyze and reproduce the reported results. So let's start with reporting the results. First from MonetDB. On the left-hand side, you see the cumulative execution time to execute all 113 join order benchmark queries in comparison to MonetDB's default join ordering. The figure on the left-hand side already reveals a tremendous speed up of query execution times for all queries, no matter the index configuration. So we use a primary key index only or a combined index of primary key and a foreign key. But more interesting, if you look at the right-hand side, you see the execution time for the longest running query of both approaches, which reveals that we can really circumvent very long running queries because our join order takes at most 2 seconds, while the default MonetDB join ordering takes up to 45 seconds. A similar picture we can observe for the Postgres database system. However, our experiments here indicate that Postgres generally finds decent join orderings, but occasionally again runs into very long running queries, which take up to 57 seconds, while our longest running query takes up to 6 seconds. Yet our enumeration approach is agnostic to Postgres fine-tuned cost model and only relies on applying hash joins. So to rule out the influence of the join operator, we force Postgres as well to only use hash joins, which again confirms that we achieve a superior join order and again recommend very long running queries. Okay, so far we addressed the upper bound and enumeration part of our approach, and we showed some preliminary results on the join order benchmark. The join order benchmark, however, really focuses on the join ordering itself and comes with very simple filter expressions. We argue that in reality, filter expressions can be much more complex in real-world OLAP scenarios, as they might be machine-generated and overspecified. And in these scenarios, traditional histograms do not seem to be sufficient to estimate decent filter selectivities. Out of these reasons, we propose a customized sampling approach tailored to in-memory columnar stores that gives precise and fast estimates. So we can only overview some core ideas here, and for more insights, please look at the paper. So the first approach we call focus sampling, where we exploit very specific access patterns of in-memory columnar stores. And further, we avoid building up a separate sample table aside from the base table tuples. Combining these ideas really boosts sampling speed, as you can see on the right-hand side, no matter the predicate complexity. Our experiments, moreover, revealed that you can have a very selective sub-expression within a complex filter predicate that disqualifies almost all, if not all, sample tuples. To circumvent these situations, we propose conditional sampling, where we apply an index to sample tuples that are more meaningful in terms that they have a chance to qualify the combined filter expression. And our experiment here reveals that targeting these tuples under the condition that a very selective sub-expression already qualifies gives very precise estimates. In fact, we achieve superior estimates with 1/10 of the sample size compared to the traditional approach. So this brings me already to the end of this talk, where we present a very simple yet fast and effective joint ordering concept in our paper. So the most outstanding part is its simplicity. So everyone can look at the plans, understand the plans. It comes without any aggressive assumptions, without relying on magic constants or damping factors. Moreover, it really helps to circumvent very long running queries, as we have seen on the join order benchmark. And it is completely independent of very complex filter expressions. and scales very well in the number of joins. So thank you for your attention. And now I should be ready to take your questions.